गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट प्लांट अग्निमंत। अग्नि मतनाति दीपनत्वात्। अग्निमंत इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्लांट ड्यूरिंग द वैदिक पीरियड एज इट्स ड्राई स्टिक्स वेयर रब टू जनरेट फायर। सो इट इज ऑल्सो यूज फॉर रिचुअल्स। इट इज इंक्लूडेड अंडर दशमूल ग्रुप ऑफ 10 ड्रग्स वेयर यूजफुल पार्ट इज रूट। In Ayurveda, we come across these plants known by the name Agnimanta. Brihat Agnimanta is represented by plant species Premna micrometata, Premna integripolia, Premna serratifolia. Laghu or Kshudra Agnimanta is represented by Clerodendron pomidis. Scientific classification of the plant Agnimanta: Kingdom Plantae, Subkingdom Verde Plantae or Green Plants, Division Tracheophyta or Vascular Plants, Subdivision Spermatophytes, Class Magnoliopsida, Order Lamiales, Family Verbenaceae, Kula Nirgundicula, Genus Clerodendron, Species Pomidis. Agnimanta included under some of the ganas by Brihatrayas and Laghutrayas. Charaka included in Shotahara, Sheeta Prashamana and Anvasanopaga. Shushruta under Viratarvadi, Varunadi, Vata Samshamana and Brihat Panchamuda. Vagbhata under Viratarvadi and Varunadi and Bhavamishra under Guduchyadi. Some important vernacular names of the plant Agnimanta. In English, it is headache tree. In Hindi, Arani, Agatu, Taker. Kannada, Taggi or Taggi Beru. Malayalam, Munja. Marathi, Takli Moola. Telugu, Taluki. Bengali, Ganiyari or Arani. Tamil, Pachimulai. Gujarati, Arani, Arani Moola. And Oriya Ganiyari. Some important synonyms of the plant Agnimanta. On habitat, it is Nadeyi, grows abundantly nearby the river. On popularity or rudi, it is Tarkari, as plant having very good qualities. On leaves, it is Shriparni, as leaves are beautiful. Gandhapatra, leaves emits odor. On bark, it is Tanutvak, as plant having thinnest bark. Some synonyms based on sense organs. On Shabda, Kanika, which makes a typical sound while breaking. Rupa, Ganikarika, Ketu, Vaijayantika, as inflorescence exhibited like banner, or inflorescence is beautiful. Gandha, Gandhapatra, Gandhapushpa, Gandhamoola, as these parts like Patra, Pushpa, Moola emits odor. On pharmacological actions of the plant, it is having synonym Jaya, Jayanti, Vijaya. It gives a meaning that this plant gives victory over many diseases. And it also having synonym Vatagni, as it best in management of Vatavikara. Habitat of the plant: it is available in upper Gangetic Plains, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and Orissa. It is also available in coastal areas of southern India and dry regions of western coast. Now let us discuss about controversies regarding Agnimanta and its synonym in Ayurveda. In Rajanigantu and Nigantu Ratnakara, Brihat Agnimanta claimed as Premna integrifolia and Kshudra Agnimanta as Clerodendron pomidis. In Materia Medica of Ayurveda, only one type of Agnimanta is described, that is Clerodendron pomidis. Explanation available in Ayurveda formulary of India creates a little confusion regarding the genuinity of the plant Agnimanta. In the AFI part 1st edition 1st, Clerodendron pomidis considered as Juna and Agnimanta, and substitutes are Premna integrifolia and Premna micronata. In AFI part 1st, edition 2nd, Premna integrifolia considered as Agnimanta, and substitutes are Clerodendron pomidis and Premna micronata. In AFI part 2nd, edition 1st, Clerodendron pomidis considered as Agnimanta, and substitutes are Premna opticifolia and Premna micronata. Some other statements which creates confusion regarding juvenility of the Agnimanta are like Tarkari, which is regarded as synonym of Agnimanta. Shruta has considered both Agnimanta and Tarkari in one group. In Dravyaguna Vijnana, Agnimanta considered as Premna micronata and Tarkari as Clerodendron pomidis. However, throughout Kerala, Premna species is used as a substitute of Agnimanta as well as Tarkari. But Tarkari is a synonym which refers to Premna integrifolia, Sesbinia, Egyptica and Cassia tora. While going through the previous references, it is very difficult to decide the original source of plant Agnimanta. But the reference of Rajanigantu, that is Agnimanta dvayam chaivam tulyam virya rasadishu tan prayoga anusarena yojayet swamanaushadaha, this reference indicates that both the varieties, that is Brahat and Kshudra Agnimanta, have the similar properties. Because of this reason, one can be used as substitute for the other. Now, let us discuss about the botanical description of Brahat Panchamoola, that is Premna integrifolia. Its habit, it is a large shrub or small tree with the spinous branches. Leaves broadly oblong or ovate, entire or dentate. Flowers indents, corium, greenish white with unpleasant smell. Fruit is a drupe, black colored globose. Seeds oblong, flowering in between April to June. Brahat Agnimanta is a large shrub with ovate leaves. Inflorescence of the plant Agnimanta is very beautiful, so it is indicated by the synonym Ganikarika, Ketu and Vaijayanti. Fruits of Brahat Agnimanta, initially they are white to greenish and turns to black. Now let us discuss about botanical description of Laghu or Kshudra Agnimanta, that is Clerodendron pomidis. Habit, it is a large bushy shrub. Leaves ovate, sinuate or serrate and pubescent. Inflorescence axillary cymes. Flower white colored, fragrant, borne on a terminal rounded panicle. Fruit black and slightly succulent. Laghu or Kshudra Agnimanta, that is Clerodendron pomidis, is also a large bushy shrub with leaves which are ovate or serrate. Inflorescence of Kshudra Agnimanta is axillary cyme with white or pink colored flowers. Fruit initially green and later turns to black. Now let us see the chemical constituents of the plant Brahat Agnimanta, that is Premna integrifolia. It is having beta citosterol, luteolin, and its leaves have premnine, betuline, Ganyarin, Ganikarin, and Premnalol. Chemical constituents of Laghu or Kshudra Agnimantha, that is Clerodendron Fomidis: Pectolinergenin, Scutellarin, Apigenin, Hispodilin, Clerosterol, Clerodin, Clerodendrin, Cyril Alcohol, and Raffinin. Rasapanchakas of Brahat and Kshudra Agnimantha are same as per Rajanikanthu, both having the same rasas like Tikta, Katu, Kashaya, Madhura, Gunas, Ruksha and Laghu, Virya, Ushna and Vipaka, Katu. Action of Rasapanchaka on Dosha Dhatu Mala. On Dosha, it is Kapha and Vatushamaka. On Dhatu, it is Rakta Shodhaka. On Mala, it is Malastambaka. Systemic action of the plant Agnimantha on nerve system, it is useful in neuralgia and it is best analgesic. On digestive system, it is best digestant. On circulatory system, it is useful in bleeding disorders. It is vasodilator as well as blood purifier. On respiratory system, it is useful in cough, asthma and cold. On urinary system, it is useful in pyuria, and on skin, it is useful in urticaria. Useful part of the plant Agnimantha are leaves and root. Posology or matra of Agnimantha: churna 250 milligrams to 1 gram in children, in adults 1 gram to 3 gram, and the best time is after food with warm water. Quatha 10 ml to 50 ml in children, 50 ml to 100 ml in adults, and the best time to use is half an hour before the food and 2 hours after the food. Safety profile of plant Agnimantha: Agnimantha is considerably safe when it is used either in the form of crude or in natural form. Its preparations like Agnimantha powder, Agnimantha juice and Agnimantha decoction are very safe for the use. Agnimantha side effects: there are no side effects observed if Agnimantha used after analyzing the dosha. Use of Agnimantha in pregnant women and breastfeeding babies: Agnimantha preparations are best to avoid during pregnancy because its safety profile for women is not well established. Agnimantha is likely to be safe for lactating mothers and breastfeeding babies. There are no adverse effects reported. Dashimurla Arista, which consists of Agnimantha, is commonly used during postpartum period to prevent postpartum diseases. Indications of plant Agnimantha: as per Rajanikanthu, Tarkari Katurusna Chatikta Anila Kapapaha Shopajushma Agnimandyarti Vidpandadmana Nashini. This reference indicates it is useful in Shota, Pandu, Agnimandya, Vibandha, Staulya, Sheetapitta, Udardha and Kota. Therapeutic uses of plant Agnimantha: Vasameha, Agnimantha or Shimshapakvata is useful. In Shota, Aranikshara mixed with water and used internal as well as external. In Staulya, Shilajatu given along with Agnimantha Swarasa. In Granthi Visarpa, paste of Agnimantha and Vamsha leaves used for local application. In Arsha, Avagaha Sveda of decoction of leaves of Agnimantha which is best in Shushkarsha. In Benga, paste of Agnimanta bark pounded with Ajidugdha is pasted. Some important preparations are Vishishta Yoga of Agnimanta, Agnimanta Adikashayam, Agnimanta Moola Kalka, Dashamoola Kashayam Arkvata, Dashamoola Katutrayadi Kashayam, Dashamoola Haritaki, Dashamoola Churna, Dashamoola Taila, Chitraka Haritaki, Dashamoola Rasayana, Dashamoola Arista, Danvantaram Kashaya, Dashamoola Shatfalagrata, Maharasnadi Kvata, Narayana Taila, and Kamsa Haritaki. Some recent research activities on Agnimanta. Therapeutic efficacy of Agnimanta in Stavlya. Effect of Agnimanta Kashaya in Prameha. Clinical efficacy of Shilajatu processed with Agnimanta in Stavlya. Clinical efficacy of Agnimanta on arthritis. An in vitro evaluation of efficacy of Agnimanta active against gram-positive organisms. Some important references of the plant Agnimanta. Tarkari Katuka Tikta, Tuvara Madhura Agnita, Viryosnam Harate, Vatakafa Shwetu Pandutaha. As per Kayadevanigantu Aushadi Varga, Agnimanto Kunestad Dadvi Visheshad Vata Shopaha. As per Kayadevanigantu Aushadi Varga, अग्निमंतः श्वेतुनुद्ध वीरोष्ण कफवातुनुद्ध पांडुनुत्कटुक स्तिक्त तुवरो मधुर अग्निदः. इट इज आल्सो एज पर कैदेव निघंटु औषधि वर्ग. तरकारी कटुरुष्ण चतिक्त अनिल कपापः शोपजुष्मा अग्निमान्द्यार्ति वेटबंधात्मान नाशिनी. एज पर राजनिघंटु प्रभद्रादि वर्ग. नाउ references of Kshudragnimanta. Agnimanta dvayam chaivam tulyam vire rasadishu tan prayoganusarena yojayet swamana shoshadaha. It is also as per Rajanigantu Prabhadradi Varga.